It's time for some more Doom. What up, gamers?
I'm about to have a meltdown.
I agree, especially if I keep using these cringy-ass openings.
Guess who's back?
We are back here for another week of Doom, and we have our guest with us. Welcome back.
What
to
up?
Yeah. Oh no, we got dialogue. Now I gotta pay attention.
No, you don't.
I kind of forget where we left off.
Mars is invaded by demons. Shit is real. And we gotta stop the meltdown that's happening.
Challenges.
Was this right after you met the girl? I forget her name.
Oh yeah, Olivia Pierce. Okay, yeah. Okay. We're trying to stop her. We're trying to stop her from opening portals. Thanks for that. I forgot the story in this game. For reference, it's been a couple of weeks since the last recording session with Christmas. Yeah, we gotta get ourselves another upgrade. Like the combat shotgun upgrade, this is probably going to be the main one you use for this weapon. The other one of these micro missiles, I don't really use too much. Their damage is not that great. But with this one, we can do headshots. And it does higher amounts of damage on any kind of critical point, which is usually the head. And it can be different on other types of health creatures.
What was the upgrade itself? It was the scope?
Yep.
Okay.
Okay. It kind of looked awkward. How you were using it, but maybe you're just not great at aiming with it.
No, I'm not. I'm not used to ADS in this game, so I'm usually pretty clumsy at it, because it's Doom. Yeah. You don't need ADS. Aiming, there is a lot of auto-aiming turned on, even with mouse and keyboard. You should probably just leave it on.
Mm-hmm.
With how frantic this game gets, it's... You
that
don't
demon's
have
got
to
some buns!
So, that is our,
Oh, shit!
Oh.
I don't have the double jump yet. Fuck.
I thought you died. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, fun fact, there's lava all over this level. I don't get to show it off here because I didn't die like that. But, if you fall into the lava, you have a random chance of dying, of doing the thumbs up pose that Arnold Schwarzenegger did in Terminator 2.
That's cool.
Mm-hmm.
So,
I think every game that has a lava death needs to have that.
I agree. Because apparently there's zero copyright on it. If Doom can do it, you can too.
Yeah. It's just a guy putting his thumb up.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of no copyright, that Steamboat Willie, like the classic Mickey Mouse, just became like open. I forget the term for it, but... became usable to the public now. Public domain,
Public
that's
domain,
the word I'm looking for.
Yeah, and they instantly made a horror game.
Yeah.
Yeah. like everything.
When I saw that, I had the same reaction to Blood and Honey of, this is a movie to somebody, but not me.
I kind of want to see that, just to see how bad it's going to be.
There's also...
Is it not out yet?
It is.
Oh,
it is.
Okay.
There's also a boomer shooter that's kind of replicating the original Disney style and that cartoon style, but that was announced well before this because it doesn't copyright infringe. A lot of people are linking it to it, but it's, if you look at footage, it's pretty different overall. But that one looks pretty cool too.
But now they could use Steamboat Willie Mouse. Specifically that version though, not any other version.
Yeah. So this level's kind of neat. Your only objective is destroy these gore nests, which obviously just activated an arena. After this first one, it is one of the only levels in the game that's pretty non-linear. You can go through each of the three routes, and you'll slowly unlock the other routes as you go. Mm. You can go to anyone you choose. So that's kind of cool. It's like one of the only levels that doesn't have a linear path through, or a partially linear path, slightly opening up.
The more you play this game, the more I realize it's just like a playable Michael Bay film.
You know what?
Michael Bay saw this, got it wrecked, and was like, how do I get the film rights? And then found out they were making a shitty film. So he said.
65%. This is exactly what the Doom Michael Bay movie would look like, though, if this game hadn't
released. He'd make it all in first person.
Yeah. Be like that one movie where it's basically just told through a GoPro. I don't remember what it's called. No, that's just like a found footage film.
Oh no.
There was like a movie. I don't know if it ever got finished or whatever, but it was like a first-person perspective movie, and it was weird.
Was it horror?
No, it was like a.
Oh.
I think I know what you're talking about, but I don't know the title.
Yeah. I only saw like glimpses of it, and to me it was like, oh, there, it's just like, wow, look, it's a video game, but it's a movie instead.
Yeah. So this is the first of many times. This is gonna be the first of many times where I get distracted looking for something on the map. Sometimes I give up, other times I do make it.
How many times are you gonna do this jumping sequence?
Hopefully the last time. I don't remember.
Because I did play this level. And I did this jumping sequence at least 15 times because I just kept falling down.
Yeah,
I don't think I ended up playing this far.
It's a little hard.
Yeah.
Platforming games are one of my favorite, though. Mm-hmm. I love platforming games.
Yeah, they're my bread and butter in terms of video games.
I've been playing through the Blaster Master Zero series lately. So good. Really, really good platformer, especially the sequel. I haven't finished it yet, but for some reason, NT Creates, whenever they make a game, their sequels improve upon the original in every way. So if you're at all into, like, 8-bit retro style platformers, play it. It's good.
Have you played Shovel Knight?
Yes.
Oh,
I got that on 3DS before it went out. Best decision I ever made.
My problem with Shovel Knight, though, is, like, I get so exhausted when I go to replay the game.
I agree.
It's so long. Like, each level is, like, 30 minutes after a certain point.
I tried getting through Plague of Shadows, and I was absolutely loving the gameplay, but because the levels are still the same length as before, that was kind of killing it for me after playing Shovel of Hope.
Yeah.
What upgrade are you going to choose?
Oh, we got some armor. All right.
Armor.
I would just keep choosing health. That's just the kind of player I am.
The true goat is armor and ammo, either of those two. Because health goes down really, really fast.
Yeah, but I get like a weird sense of satisfaction in video games where when I get like a permanent health upgrade. So, I don't know.
Can you still get one shot by those fireball things? Even with all that armor? No.
No. With armor, you're fine. You're going to be probably at one shot left after that. That's why you want to have armor. But just standard health at 100, it'll one shot you.
Mm.
Believe me, I tested it enough times. Thankfully, I'm semi competent good at editing. A lot of asterisks there. Please don't ever ask me to edit something.
It takes a lot of practice, to be honest.
Alright, I'm finally using the platformer.
I forgot you
had
it.
In its glory, because once I get a weapon called the fuck.
Oh.
Called the fuck.
All you know, it's a giant dildo. It deals extra damage if you go for the ass. It deals extra damage when you go for the ass, you know. No.
South Park? What the fuck? That's some South Park ass shit.
If South Park had a good first-person shooter that wasn't on the N64, that would be a weapon. I'm calling it now.
It was a weapon in Stick of Truth.
Was it really?
Yeah, and it's the best weapon in the game.
I gotta try out Stick of Truth, because this isn't it a turn-based RPG?
Yeah, it's amazing. I love it.
I feel like I love it.
Did you?
It's incredible.
Did you ever play,
Hey, look, it's that platforming sequence again.
Yeah. Did you ever play Saints Row the Third, or whatever it's called?
I might have long ago.
Okay, well, that game has a dildo bat. And one of my professors in college was actually the guy that made it. So
what?
Yeah.
Like he was a game programmer? Game designer?
Yeah, he was like That's cool. like an artist and he made the freaking dildo bat. And That's then when the game shipped, him and his like team went out to dinner. And they like presented to him a like 3D printed life size version of the dildo bat.
That's amazing.
In public.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Hopefully he still has it.
Oh, I'm sure he does. I'm sure he does.
This is for you, Dion. I didn't cut out the upgrade sequences this time. Like
good.
In Dark Souls.
Good. Yeah, I don't know if you watched any of our Dark Souls playthrough, D'Souza, but he just cut out every time he opened a menu. And I was so confused trying to follow along what he was doing. Because like he would cut... He would cut, and then he'd be wearing completely different armor, he'd have a different weapon on.
So even, like, shop menus would be edited out?
Yeah. No, I think... Okay.
You kept some of them in.
My brother was playing a lot of that playthrough, because he's way better at the game than me. And he would take, like, 3 minutes in shops, just customizing everything. So it was either leave that all in or take it out, and I'm sorry.
That's like me when I play Dark Souls, though. I love to look at everything and do everything.
You can't speed it up, so you just cut it out.
See, what I would do in that case would be I would like show the menu normally for the first couple times, and then after a few times, I would like just sort of speed through it. Or maybe
what did
put
we
some
just
text
talk about with
screen.
Me and editing?
Just, you have this wonderful device that can access Google.
Nope. More demons. Oh.
Oh, that's a big ass motherfucker.
All right. That so this is our first. This is our first big boy, heavy demon. This is a Hell Knight. One of the reasons we got the scope is because his head has a lot of extra damage compared to other enemies. So if you actually have a good aim, unlike me, you can shred him. Now these guys, unlike
kill.
Other demons, will rush you and will pummel you, dealing heavy damage. They are intimidating at first, but later on they are complete pushovers and a non-issue.
I just wanted to say that glory kill on that Hell Knight was like
super underwhelming.
Underwhelming as hell. His head just vanished.
I was so ready to see something cool, and it was just a beatdown.
Yeah, it was like punch and the head vanished.
I think one of my favorite glory kills is from Doom Eternal, where when you punch a demon, he'll like bop the head in like whack-a-mole. It looks like a shitty B horror movie from the 80s.
That's funny.
Where the head is just kind of caved, where the head is just kind of shoved into your shoulders, and the body just crumples over. It's hilarious. Oh, I'm bad at secret finding. We're gonna be here a bit.
Yay!
Nope, I gave up. All right, we're good.
That was quick.
Oh, that looked like a secret lever right there.
Yeah.
Well, you got better eyesight than me.
I didn't even see it.
It was on the little cart thing on the bridge.
He'll probably walk over there again.
I'm just gonna vibe to the music now.
What's those things on the top right of your screen? Symbols.
Oh, those are map challenges. I try to do a lot of them,
kills,
but some
or?
Of them... they can be different kinds of challenges. Like, get so many kills. But a lot of them are dumb, where you have to get specific glory kills. So, like...
No!
Oh,
if you
shit.
Aim for a demon's leg, you'll, like, usually hit their leg to slide them on the ground and then smash their head in. That's one of them. There's death from above, like you saw me do earlier, where you jump on a demon and smash their head in. Other ones, you have to be near a wall. And it's really, really annoying to try and specifically do these. And if you just let the gameplay go naturally, you're probably not going to get them. So I just don't worry about the specific glory kill challenges.
Yeah.
That's I'll try to do as many as I can, but some of them just get done.
That's like the same sort of thing in, oddly enough, Spider-Man PS4. Because, like, every street brawl in that game has its own set of little challenges.
Oh, yeah.
And I just don't have time for that shit.
Are they, like, randomized?
No, kind it's, of. Like, I think it's for... It's set for each, like, street brawl that there is. But you can't really tell them apart. So... Yeah. I just don't fucking bother.
I think I had to for the platinum in Miles Morales, if I'm remembering correctly.
At least that game is a bit smaller than the original.
Y'all are insane. I have no idea why either of you ever go for 100% in games.
Dopamine.
Fair enough. Fair
That's it.
I suppose, but like...
To feel some sort of accomplishment.
I've been playing a lot of JRPG, and I refuse to ever 100% those one day.
Well, JRPGs are fucking massive.
They're better than games with multiplayer achievements that require thousands of hours.
Those are games I will never try to 100%.
Yeah.
Don't 100% this game, then. It has multiplayer achievements, and its multiplayer is dead.
Hey, you know what? I started a recording of my own on this, like, a year ago. And without really looking at the trophies, and then I seen the trophies, and I was like, nah.
Well, couldn't you still, like, make, like, a private lobby or something, and do them that way?
Usually trophies are locked out of private matches. Online trophies.
Yeah, but again, there's just so many, it's like, what's the point? I get that it's for clout, but if you have to go and not play the game in the intended way just to get them, I feel like...
Oh, shit!
I feel like it's not worth it, you know? He ain't got nothing on me. He's a pussy.
Any more jump scares I have to be careful of?
He just leaped, like, across the entire freaking room. That was kind of scary.
No, I mean, remember last time there was some like cutscene jump scare that scared the fuck out of me last time. I really didn't see it coming. I don't know why. I don't even remember what happened. I just remember shitting myself.
I guess one of these guys technically has a
life. Oh yeah.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. You didn't expect him to be alive. That happened some more times, and I'm sorry.
Every game pulls that freaking stunt. If they have zombies.
You would hate Dead Space.
I've played Dead Space before. I bought the remake, but I haven't finished it.
I gotta get through the remake. I enjoyed the hour I played of it. Especially compared to the original. I really like the original.
I played like the first two chapters and that was it.
Is the remake of that like faithful or is it like pretty different?
Extremely faithful.
It's pretty different.
Okay. Oh, well, okay.
Conflicting reports.
Okay. The original has an atmosphere created through sound design and a heavy use of jump scares. And then the remake still has an atmospheric sound design, but is way later on the jump scares. And they're heavily toned down. The remake also has a voiced character instead of a silent protagonist. So he now has a lot more agency on the story. Instead of you'll hear go through that. Like, nothing against the original, but they are very different feeling, and I think it's to the remake's benefit. Another thing is zero load screens in a seamlessly connected world. So they play around with actually revisiting areas a lot more than the original, where in the original, unless you were told to, you never really had reason to go back to any previous area.
Man, I thought so I knew a lot about games.
You just opened your eyes.
I don't know shit no more. I thought it was the same.
I'm sorry for talking.
What?
He said he's sorry for talking.
Oh no. Don't be. I'm just simple, I guess.
I have no idea where this fucking secret is, and I'm stupid.
Nah,
we're gonna be here a bit.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, okay.
There it is. It was in the box. All right.
I like how it plays like the 8-bit music.
Yeah, it's great. We gotta bring back the Bobby Prince score. There's that should be an option. I don't know if it's copyrighted at all, but there should be like an option to just turn that on. I love Mick Gordon's music, but I would love to play this game with the original soundtrack.
Man, there's an option for that in the Mario RPG remake.
Fuck. Where did he come from?
What an asshole.
I didn't see him. I don't know if you guys did.
Man, he has some webbed-ass toes.
I did.
Frog
talking
feet.
About the demon's toes.
I don't know what that is. Okay. Thanks for explaining.
Anywhere?
There's that.
There was a heavy debate there whether, am I going to survive? Ah, fuck it, let's try.
Grenade.
Was that necessary?
Yeah, it saves ammo if you use the grenade. They recharge.
Oh, way.
You're going to see it a lot more whenever I get to Doom Eternal, because that has a lot more options to destroy demons without wasting ammo.
In a game where you have limited ammo, you somehow have infinite grenades. That makes sense.
Yeah. Trust me, it makes sense when you play the game.
Well, I'm sure it's good gameplay, I'm just being an asshole.
You know, it's better than downloading missiles.
I disagree, I think that's
and
cool.
Still having to physically pick up missile drops. From creatures that roam around a facility or a planet. Just saying.
They gotta eat something.
This is off of Metroid, by the way. I don't know if you've ever played those ones.
I've played Metroid, but not heavy enough to know stuff like that.
Nah, we're big Metroid fans over at Crazy Jelly Commentary's trademark.
I really like the original Metroids. But any like ones other than past Super Metroid, I haven't really played.
Well, Fusion and Metroid Prime 1 at least, and Metroid Dread are amazing video games.
I have Metroid Dread, I just haven't really played it. I have so many games in the backlog.
Like, at least Metroid Dread can be beaten around like 5 hours.
Oh really? Is it that short?
It's
heavily replayable.
It depends, like, if you're like being very explorative, it'll probably take you a lot longer. It took me
like
about
Super Metroid,
10 hours
just,
on my first run.
Like Super Metroid, it just depends on how long you want to take. What a bitch. And the grenade miss. Alright. Oh, I did talk about resources that don't use ammo. I guess there's also the pistol that has infinite ammo, but like, I'm not gonna use it.
That thing's retired.
Too big. I'm lost.
It's not big. There's a lot of paths in it, but that's what you gotta use the big map for. Because again, this is a relatively small map. It's just a big open area, because a lot of it's easily explored.
Holy fuck! Look at that map screen. Good god.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Like we've been here for 23 minutes, and there's still like a lot of ground to cover. It looks like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess I just proved your point.
Get that guy, yeah.
Curb stomp.
You bastard. You don't get ahead anymore.
I think this game definitely needed more glory kill animations.
Yeah.
What are those things right there? Are they eggs?
They're called gore nests.
Oh.
They are big things of energy that allow demons to teleport in. So when you damage it, they're like, oh shit, we better go stop him and rebuild it or something.
You're gonna fucking die.
It's just an excuse for an arena. Ow.
Oh, the health is right
what
there.
What hit you?
No.
Oh my god.
I don't have a stomach.
You saw it for a second. There was like a laser that came from behind him.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna get hit, and it's gonna feel unfair a lot. Okay, you can tell I died a lot here because I'm being very careful.
And then you whiff that grenade.
Actually, that grenade earlier went where it was supposed to.
Well, the first one did.
See, it killed most of the demons down here.
But then you did the like chakran grenade.
Oh.
And you just shot it straight at a wall.
I'm about to say, I didn't think I had two grenade slots yet. I think that's later.
Oh. What the fuck happened?
Just freaking zipped past him.
Yeah, sometimes it doesn't hit fully.
I still can't believe you decided to play this on Nightmare difficulty or whatever it's called. Like extreme.
It's fun. At least this isn't the one death or the permadeath mode.
Oh god. This would be a 100-parter.
I agree. Does Evil Within have one of those?
It does not. But it has a mode where you die in one hit no matter what, so it could tickle your pinky toe and you'll die. Yeah, you had to do that for the platinum, and it was kind of a pain, but there was checkpoints and they were relatively often.
Okay.
So it was bearable, but it was very, very annoying because there's a bunch of stuff in that game that like can just do like minimal damage to you in a regular playthrough, but on that mode, insta-dead. And in that mode, everything has like 10 times the health as well, so.
Oh, of course. They just did a lasso run from Halo, but without skulls.
It was called Akumu mode, and I think Akumu is like nightmare in Japanese or something like that. I'm not 100% sure. Not a Japanese major, but.
I am learning the language, but I don't know. I'm sure I could look it up.
But yeah, thank god no permadeath modes. I'm scared to do a permadeath game.
If I were a live streamer and could monetize it, I would play it. I think the strat I've seen for this game on its permadeath mode is each time, you have multiple play slots, so what you do is when you get to a level, you play that level on Nightmare multiple times through, so you can play it consistently without dying.
Yeah.
And then play it on Alternate Mare. So you kind of do practice runs. It's kind of the way I've seen it done. But other people just brute force it, and if you die, you die. But they've also, there are probably also people who only play on Nightmare and have played it a ton beforehand, I would assume.
I've been wanting to do Outlast 2, but that's got permadeath and not only permadeath, but permadeath without reloading your camera battery. So
yeah, I think we talked about that last time. That sounds horrible.
Yeah.
I think
why would anyone want to do that?
The game Amnesia does the same thing, where to get one of the trophies, you have to pick up every tinderbox in the game. But the best way to count that is to never use the tinderboxes. So you're just always in darkness and always going insane.
Yeah.
Which really hurts the game because going insane doesn't actually do anything in the game other than visual effects, and it really, really ruins the atmosphere when you play through the game relying on that. You're not supposed to know that playing the game. Unfortunately, it's old and everyone knows that.
Wolfenstein has another really, really hard permadeath mode, too.
Of course it has a permadeath.
Wolfenstein, the new Colossus. It's a super popular, like, hard platinum trophy.
Is this
I would love
new
to
Colossus,
go for
or is this new one
yeah.
too?
No, specifically New Colossus is like the more well-known one for being difficult.
Okay. I need to play that one. I've loved New Order. I haven't played the sequel.
It's just because it's like, it's Wolfenstein, so it's hard to begin with, but then you're playing on the hardest difficulty where pretty much everything one-shots you. Everybody has a gun. So,
yeah.
You gotta play it so slow and so careful, and then
what do you do against the mechs?
You literally have to, like, corner camp and take cover. Like, play it like you're playing veteran on Call of Duty campaign or something, like. And then if you die, there's like 20 minutes.
And that at least feels like it should, because you're supposed to use cover and such.
Yeah. You have to play the game like in a completely different way that you're not really supposed to play the game. But on top of that too, if you die, there's 20 minutes of unskippable cutscenes in the intro.
So, why would they do that?
Yeah.
If you play, I think it's Batman Arkham Origins, that one has a permadeath mode. But when you do the Deathstroke boss fight, there's a quick time event section. And if you fail that, I think once, it counts as a death.
No, that sucks.
So, you can lose an entire permadeath run to a fucking quick time event.
If you guys ever want to turn Minecraft into a horror game, play it in VR on hardcore mode.
Can you play Minecraft VR?
Yeah, there's like a fan-made mod for the Java edition that is like a really good way to play it in VR. There's also technically the like official VR for Bedrock, but Bedrock, you don't want to play Bedrock, so.
I just recently plugged it in my VR again, and it gave me a headache. I played for like 30 minutes. Oh my god. The Room VR. It's like a puzzle game.
I played The Room.
Yeah. It's really fun. Like, I used to play it on just like the phone or whatever, but they have like a whole PlayStation VR version of it, and it's really good.
Yeah.
But it was the first time I played VR in like 6 months, and I got a bad headache.
Yeah. Well, making a puzzle game your first VR game back probably wasn't the best idea.
Making my brain work
yeah.
even more than it has to, processing yeah,
it's
that.
Like, I'm in a whole freaking different world right now, and I gotta use my brain? This sucks.
Well, it was either that or play Resident Evil VR, or Five Nights at Freddy's VR. So...
Have you played... So you said Resident Evil 7's your favorite...
Yeah.
Game. Have you played the VR mode for that ever?
I have not, because it is exclusive to PS4 VR, and I have PS5 VR, and they haven't made it cross-platform yet. And I'm kind of pissed
does
about
RE8
that.
Have the,
it does. VR RE8 mode? Has VR, and then RE4 just got, the remake just got a VR mode as well, that are both on the PSVR 2. But of course, my favorite Resident Evil game isn't cross-platform, or cross-gen, I mean. And,
So, I've always been confused about the Resident Evil VR things, though. Do they have, like, the full-on, like, your hands are the, like, controllers? Or
oh, yeah.
Okay, because I remember, because that was the thing with Resident Evil 7, was you're still playing it with a controller, like a regular controller in VR. So...
I mean... For example, Resident Evil 8 VR, I played like halfway through it in VR when I first got it. It's really cool and actually really immersive. The PSVR 2 is honestly my favorite VR I've ever used.
Yeah, it looks really good.
Did you make it to the baby section?
I made it just before that section. That section, I'm so scared of that in VR. One, because mannequins are my worst fear. Mannequins are my worst fear, and that's like... Honestly, yeah. Like that whole section. I don't know why mannequins are my worst fear. I go into clothing stores and I get so anxious. I'm dead serious. I start walking to the other side of the aisle. If there's a mannequin on my right, I'll hug the left.
That's like being elevators. Or not elevators, escalators. Escalators. I do everything I can to avoid them.
But yeah, no, it's really cool. I mean, like, to reload your gun, you have to press a button and then, like, shake your hand to shake the mag out. And then you gotta reach into your pocket and grab the other mag and put it in and cock it back.
I have the Quest 2, and I really wanted to play the, like, proprietary RE4 Oculus Quest 2 port.
Yeah.
Because it looks really damn good.
Mm-hmm.
But I just haven't had motivation to play VR lately.
I'm super new to it, and it still kind of blows my mind a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I have touched it. I haven't touched it at all outside of a single playthrough of Beat Saber by my uncles.
Beat Saber is, it's a good VR game, but I feel like it's not an insane VR experience. You know, it's just like Guitar Hero.
it's
different than being in an actual world like Resident Evil VR.
Right. Mm-hmm. I gotta play more of it though. I love rhythm games.
Same.
Especially any that have J-pop, which is why I only ever play ones from Japan.
You a DDR fan then?
I have never gotten to play DDR. I don't know, because they don't really make it for home anymore, do they? And there's no arcades near me.
Yeah, true.
So I mostly just play on console.
Just buy Mario Dance Dance Revolution for the GameCube and get the little pad for it.
They have that for the Wii too, don't they?
I think. I have no clue. It may be. Even if they don't, the GameCube game would work on the Wii.
All right, so let's talk about the game for a bit. That was Olivia Pierce. We failed. She did the bad thing. She opened the portal even further. So now it's going to be complete chaos.
Oh no, I have more demons to shoot.
I agree. Like, this is a tragedy. What am I going to do if I just shoot more demons?
This is Doomslayer's wet dream.
He's frothing at the mouth right now.
Oh, you almost got the challenge.
I didn't kill three possessed with one explosive arrow. Oops.
At least you got all the upgrades.
Yeah.
Only two secrets missing too. Pretty good run.
I think that there might be like a single level I actually 100%, but probably not.
Oh.
I don't actually remember. But that was Doom Part 2. Perhaps next time we will talk more about Doom. I'm fine with this as well.
No, I wouldn't play Half-Life Alyx.